basics here. What's your fondest memory of your chef experience?
Okay, look, I'm gonna suck. It's not gonna be a good interview, I hope you know that.
Probably
Bio 30. Yeah, definitely Bio 30.
Oh, the plate at West Mount with the slippery wet wets on it.
Tanner, what was your fondest memory?
You not being here ever.
Oh. Every single play I've been in has been really fun.
The weekends, the parties.
Unfortunately, no beef for them.
Could you tell me the questions before we start the interview so I have some time to think about it?
Is Shep a TV
business? Yeah, definitely not my interview with Shep. That's definitely not my fondest memory.
Dodgeball. I have to say that I like dodgeball tournament easily. Throwing balls at people. What better experience could that be?
Any good stories of actually being in class?
No.
You're 11 chem with you, Rachel. Jumping out the windows.
Yes, like it's class. What do you want me to say?
The time when I got into a fight with Tully.
I sleep most of the time. That's it.
Who won?
Me.
This one time when Mr. Cubel told us that,
Social 20
ID
with Mr.
Fox. Oh, best times. The stories are superb.
What are you writing there?
Jamaican Playboy Club.
That's all
we gotta say.
Is that like a comment? Like, this guy's retarded? Because I wouldn't blame you.
So how exactly was your chef experience?
Well, I have to say it was really long and it was really hard.
So you're leaving chef this year at the end of your high school.
Why are you still doing it?
Best teacher of all time at Chef, and why? Go!
Mr. T.
Both of them.
Both of the T's, yeah.
And me.
And Mr. Vyshynski.
And Uncle Dave.
McIntyre, because she... Like, I love her. And Fernandez.
Yeah, Mr. Fernandez.
They're the best. They're the best.
Miss the class. All the sound. Miss the bread.
Miss Lee.
Miss Lee.
Tully!
I love them all.
Equally.
Also. Yeah, true. I have to go with Mr. Salon also. He had a solid mustache.
McIntyre.
Francis.
McIntyre.
Down.
Yeah, top
three. It's really good. I liked it. He looked like Mario.
I'd say Mr. Shalfin, he brought like stuff I was interested in into physics, which I'm not interested in.
Or Mr. Tully taught me how to rip a phone book.
You're in a fight to the death with Mr. Hackett. How do you take him down?
You don't.
Knockout?
Simply not possible.
Oh my gosh, that's impossible.
Knock out his knees.
Oh, nice.
What's available to me?
Paul's wife.
He's blindfolded and you have your hands behind your back.
I'd probably urinate myself and I'd repel him.
Jump kick.
The chair. I'll hit him repeatedly with the chair.
Feed him sugar.
That's probably the way to do it. I don't know. What is the stupid question?
That it's a waiting game.
With food.
Throw donuts.
I chuck a donut to the left.
Some snacks.
Food, some type of McDonald's fast food. Like.
I don't know, he likes EO.
I threw a steak the other way.
I'll throw some greasy food in the corner and run.
Slap him with a bunch of hamburger patties.
You throw a Big Mac down.
Distract him with food.
Are you kidding? I've got math arms. What am I gonna do?
I just run away. Because his calves are bigger than my quadriceps.
Well, actually, I challenge him to Wii boxing.
How do you win in a fight to the death with me? You don't.
You're stuck on a desert island. You can bring one student from Chef, one teacher from Chef, one celebrity, and one curricular item. Go!
Wait, what?
One student?
Probably a girl.
I don't know how he's been eating for a long time, yeah. I think I'd bring him along. He is taking the stories from Toby.
Jokini.
I feel awkward not saying the person beside
me. Yeah, that's
awkward. I have to choose Tanner, but I've said that. I've said I'd choose Tanner.
They get to play that Chinese instrument during the.
I'd just bring a grenade, I wouldn't bring anybody.
Probably a larger one, because you could always eat that person first.
I'd bring Josh, and he'd bring another grenade.
Who would be like the most useful teacher?
Mr. Martin. Because he's the best teacher at Chat.
Do subs count as teachers?
Why don't you ask that in the best teacher section?
Because I missed it.
Not Lina. That'd be scary.
I guess Mr. Hackett, because apparently I'm gonna have to kill him.
Just Dolly Walter.
I hear a rumor that a lot of boys have crushes on you. Are you aware of this?
No, I'm not. I was not aware of this.
Dolly
Wall for the teacher.
A celebrity.
Ooh. Maybe a dead celebrity.
Yes.
I'd probably bring Judy Dench.
bring John Mayer or Megan Fox?
Yeah.
We're together.
Selena Gomez.
No, ew, she's
Selena
like
Gomez. She's 18, I love her. Lady Gaga, because she has something interesting to say every day.
I strongly disagree.
Ewan McGregor.
Okay, so the curricular item would be a pencil.
Curricular item?
A pencil? I guess I could find food with that.
So I could put graphite in it?
Yeah.
That could be used. Fire. Light it on fire.
I'd bring a ruler. And
oh, a hot plate. You could probably do a lot of
that.
A hot plate.
You have no electricity.
And?
My pilot had the best pictures.
Oh yeah!
Dude, what are you doing?
My boots.
That's beautiful.
Can you tell?
Okay. Not very well.
Any good stories about any grade 12 students?
Young Jessica Rivers, who I met in grade 7, who was always eating candy. And they're the most hyper kid I've ever taught.
A big shout out to B. Taylor!
So I'm happy to have her in my grade 12 class right now, but good lord, stop eating the candy.
Oh, I've only been here for 3 days.
Jordan Poon running around trying to clean up hair from the carnival in grade 10.
Hair?
I had a bunch of students that tried to do biology in my class that I find a little annoying.
The carnival for the cure where we shaved the heads in the
gross.
Convinced Mackenzie Jones that one of our posters was scratch and sniff.
I can't remember the student, but there's a picture in my office where somebody made it look like it was me with Posh Spice. So when she looked at the picture, she said, "Is that you, Mr. P?" And I said, "It is." I said, we used to date, but it was a long distance relationship. And I'd always have to fly to England. So, and the student really believed it.
I think this class as a whole has been one of our best at Ross Shepherd School. I don't have any specific story I'm going to tell, but I just want to say that you guys are wonderful and we're very proud of everything you've done.
Do you have any advice to the graduating class?
Follow your heart.
Nothing in the world is accomplished without passion.
Use the two words that were given to you as some of your first two words, and that is thank you. Appreciate the benefits of those two words and use them often because you'll regret not using them later on in life.
My advice to my grade 12s is just to pursue whatever they want to do. Do good in their lives. Get a good job.
I would have to say that whatever you do, do something and do it with all your ability. That wasn't funny, was it?
I would advise to get into adventures. Safe adventures, of course.
Study hard.
As you go forward, remember who you are, remember your past and your family support, and always retain and hold on to your dreams.
Oh, pizza boxes can be an excellent source of cheese in a pinch.
Dollar.